Here are the 5 best reasons as to why you should not become a data scientist. Now, becoming a data scientist is awesome. The pay is great, you'll do cool things. And back in 2012, in an article from Harvard, the data scientist was ranked as the sexiest role of the 21st century, claiming that a data scientist will be necessary to any organization wishing to profit from big data. But becoming a data scientist is not for everyone, and there are downsides that you may want to consider. If you don't know this before, you're in a lot of trouble, because you'll waste months or years learning and job searching, all for nothing, just because you didn't understand the simple basic downsides. So let's cover them and clear everything up in 5 minutes. The first reason as to why you should not become a data scientist would be the stress and high expectations. Data scientists are very visible data people. They're not the data engineers lurking around in the background. They're the ones at the forefront, and with all the hype around data, and especially data scientists, companies tend to keep an eye on this role. They think, hey, we hired a data scientist, now we'll make 10 times more money. Okay, that's hopefully a stretch, but stakeholders and managers will sometimes look for quick returns, which can cause a lot of stress to people working these jobs. For example, it could be more about the manager looking to score some points for themselves in the short term to get a promotion, rather than doing what's best for the company by developing a solid solution, which takes time. So there can also be a lot of pressure on data scientists, and this also means that the risk of burnout could potentially be higher. They do a lot of complex things, and with this increased pressure, well, it can be a lot to handle. Am I saying that this is always the case? No. And am I saying that this is something that should stop you from becoming a data scientist? No. Or, I mean, not this reason, at least. The next reason is the constantly evolving landscape and new technology. As a data scientist, you'll have to keep learning and stay updated on everything. And it's not like having to pick up a hammer once in a while, but rather an entire new toolbox. In the tech and data fields, we've had a lot of rapid advancements recently, and now with AI, that's definitely not going to slow down anytime soon. If you're somebody that just wants to learn the skills once and then be set for life, well, you're probably not the right fit for this role. That is why it really helps if you're actually interested in data science. And I honestly believe that people that just pick data science for the money will end up struggling a lot long term. Sure, the money is really good, but I personally don't think that it's enough in the long run, because this field is really difficult. So advancements and having to learn new things can either be a gift or a curse, depending on how you see it and who you are. And if it doesn't scare you that much, then I think we can move on to the third reason. The third reason is a very confusing one, and something that isn't often discussed as often as it should, at least in my opinion. And it's the overlapping with different kind of data roles and other role differentiation in data science in general. Because ask yourself, what is a data scientist? Can you actually give me a clear answer to this question? Perhaps you'd say something along the lines of, well, they use data to help organizations make better decisions. A really, really good answer. 10 out of 10 point. But the problem is, how? Data scientists have a lot of different responsibilities, and they'll vary a lot depending on many factors, like the company and what the company actually needs. This is a problem for some, because there is a huge potential for role confusion. You can do very different things as a data scientist depending on where you work and who you work for and what the company needs. You could be more towards machine learning, or you might just be like a more technical data analyst in your company. There can also be a significant overlap between different data roles, and the data scientist can do a lot of different things depending on what's needed. So read the job description. If you get tasks you don't want to do, it could really impact your job satisfaction. But will data scientists always be needed? I haven't even mentioned the big problem here, and it's that generally speaking, things tend to go towards specialization. And what I mean is that, well, the data scientist is a pretty general data role, and as things progress, they tend to become more specialized. So there's a chance that the data scientist will end up struggling a lot in the future and have to change or just become way more specialized, because you might just have other data roles each grabbing a chunk of the data scientist's responsibilities. Okay, that was pretty harsh. So let's take another, well, pretty harsh one too. If you're still here, either you're just really motivated to become a data scientist, or you're just here to feel better about yourself while working towards another job. Excited to have you here regardless. Let's move on to reason number 4. A scientist was once ranked the sexiest job of the century, at least by some people. Do you really know what this means? Especially for the job market, because, well, people actually heard this and they listened. There are a lot of people trying to enter data science, and it's a very popular field. First, because of the great opportunities and how important it is. You can make a huge impact in data science, and yes, it is very important, but it's also because of, well, hype and a trend. Many of the people that just hopped on a trend will give up because, again, it's not easy to get into data science, but it still means that the competition may be a problem. Are there ways around it? Yes, of course. You can upskill yourself and improve to stand out, but especially as a beginner, it's certainly not an easy feat to land your first job. You may have to get another role, take on some internship, or whatever, or just really put in the work. Now, let's move on to reason number 5. The data scientist is a way more technical role than, for example, a data analyst or a business analyst. Therefore, you'll also need significantly more technical skills to become a data scientist. You'll need a strong foundation in statistics, programming, etc. And for this, many companies, they desire a bachelor's or master's, preferably in a quantitative field like computer science, statistics, economics, and so on. But listen up, I'm not saying that it's 100% impossible to get a job without a degree, but it is going to be a lot harder and the paths are kind of different. All in all, it comes with a pretty steep initial learning curve, and without a technical background, it can be really tough getting into data science. Alright, so I may have completely discouraged you, or quite the opposite, but I want to mention a few things before we finish. The data scientist is a really good role. They have a high salary, they get to call themselves scientists, I mean yay, and they have a lot of cool responsibilities. I'm not trying to discourage you or encourage you for that matter. It all depends on who you are and your goals. Do your own research and think for yourself. That's it. Check out this video next, selected by the YouTube algorithm specific for you, and I hope this was helpful. Have an amazing week, guys.